Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a look at some of the new Spotlight features in El Capitan. So let's start off by launching Spotlight, which you can do by clicking the icon up here. I like to use the keyboard shortcut, which is Command and Space, and bring it up. Now, the first thing I want to show you that's new in El Capitan is the ability to get weather. If I just type the word weather, actually it'll come up with weather for my local area. It'll also show me other things in case it's not what I wanted, like if I wanted some files or suggested websites, things like that. I can customize this. You can see there it's kind of prompting me to customize it. I could say weather in and get a more accurate forecast by typing in the name of a city like that. So I can not only find a more accurate one, but say if I'm traveling somewhere, I can get the forecast for that. And you can see it's kind of a nice forecast over here. It gives you hourly, it gives you your general forecast there, it gives you 10-day, and then a link to go to weather.com where probably this information comes from so you can get even more detailed. You can also do the same for sports. So you could type in the name of a sports team and then something like just leave it like that and it'll show you the most recent score, or you can type in schedule. And you can get information like that, and the schedule even will go further in advance. Of course, if you can do weather and you can do sports, you can do stocks. And it's easy as just typing in a stock symbol. Except that sometimes it's not, because sometimes stock symbols look like file names or something that you might be searching for. So it's more useful to type in something like stock and then the stock symbol. Great thing is it seems to work really well even if you don't know the stock symbol. Which is good, because that happens a lot. A lot of services require you to enter the stock symbol in, and if you don't know it, you have to do a lookup of the stock symbol. So it's nice to be able to do this. Now you can also search through your own files using natural language. So for instance, you can do something like documents created this week. And I find that it not only will give you documents created this week, but we'll kind of do it in ever-expanding amount. So it's kind of like when you search the web. You might search for something and the first hit may be exactly what you want, but then the second, third, fourth, and going through many pages may give you other options. So it might go beyond this week, but just be more documents. Or maybe things that aren't documents but created this week. If I had more stuff in this test account, it probably would just give me those specific items and less of the ones that may or may not fit that criteria. And you could do things like PDFs created this week. You can search emails, email sent this week, all sorts of things like that. So basically like the type of document and terms like created or updated or modified, and then things like this week, today, yesterday, this year, etc. And you can use terms like photos, for instance, and it won't search in the Photos app, but it will search for images that are stored in your user folder. For a more Siri-like experience, you can bring up Spotlight and then use Dictation, which the default is hitting the FN key twice. So if you do that and then you can speak your query, you'll automatically get a search performed. PDFs I viewed last week. Now, how Spotlight searches can be determined by going to System Preferences and then go to Spotlight, and there you can choose which items show up. So for instance, if you're sick of seeing your huge collection of fonts show up in results, you can turn that off. There's lots of other different things that you can turn on or off here that will or will not appear. Also, if there's something that you don't want it to search, like for instance you may have a folder filled with tons of files from an old project, you can add them to privacy here. Just add any folder that you want and Spotlight will then stop searching that particular folder. So you can really highly customize these things.